finger, what you have to remember is that at first, you actually start looking at that ball, and you have to keep your eye on it when you're a kid, but eventually you're able to take your eye off of it and trust yourself and trust other people with your business and with that ball. And eventually also, what you want to do is start to make the ball spin more and faster.
It's good for the end user, right? Because you and I will compete to build a greater product, and the end user gets a better product because me and him win at it. But that doesn't mean competition is good for me and him. You understand? I don't want to compete in a space. I want to dominate. I want to own space.
Connect less and grit to be able to get here. So today, I'm going to share with you that story, that journey as to what led me here to even be before you today.
I think that the first time that I started to sort of feel the ripples as my channel was growing was when I started seeing other people make work that was similar to mine, which is always the most flattering thing. It means that somebody sees what you're doing, they like what you're doing, they want to be a part of that. So influence manifests in a million different ways, but certainly when I was really finding my footing as a vlogger on YouTube, that was one of the first things I took away, was when I started seeing similar styles. I was like, wait, maybe I'm onto something here, and then it very quickly became like, maybe we are onto something here in this movement that's much bigger than me, that I was just a part of. Started to take